Now, let's look at our next tense, that is the past perfect tense. But first, let's just have a look at the formulation. I had played. So, we have the subject plus had plus the V2 form of the verb, that is the past form of the base verb play. Let's look at the other sentences. So, we have you had played, he or she had played, we had played, and they had played. Now, let's see its usage. We use this past perfect tense when we are talking about completed actions in the past, either before another action took place or before a very precise moment in the past. Well, let's understand this better with the help of these example sentences here. She arrived after we had played cards. So, we have two actions in the past here. First is, she arrived. And the second action is, we had played cards. So, just a little trick here. The second action or the later action is always going to be in the simple past tense. So, the later action is, she arrived, and the first action is, we had played cards. Now, let's look at the second sentence. When I reached the station, the train had started. So, let's apply the trick to this sentence. Which part of the sentence happened first? I think you guessed it right. The first thing is the train had started, as the second part of the sentence or the later action always is going to be in the simple past tense, which is I had reached. So, this happened next. Okay, so let's look at the past perfect tense on the timeline. This is our timeline, this is the past, this is the present, and this is the future. So, in the past perfect tense, it says that two actions in the past. Now, let's take the second sentence. When I reached the station, the train had started. So, which action takes place first? So, it is the train had started. And when did I reach the station? I reached the station when the train started. So, let's keep two things in mind here, which are very important. Past perfect tense, it denotes two actions in the past. And the second action or the later action is always in the simple past tense. And that is how we identify which one to place first and which one to place second. I hope you all have understood the usage of the past perfect tense. Now, let's get to our next tense, that is our past perfect continuous tense. The word itself sounds big and complicated, I know, but don't worry, we'll again simplify it. Let's start by having a close look at its formulation with the help of a sentence. I have been playing. So, we have the subject here, I. The had been form plus V1 with the ing. Then we have the other sentences with different pronouns here. You had been playing. He or she had been playing. We had been playing. They had been playing. Now, let's look at its usage. Action started in the past had continued for some time before another action. I know what you're thinking. It was like she just told that it's going to be simplified, and now what's this? So complicated, right? Don't worry, I'll still keep my words. We'll apply this definition to this sentence here. And it's going to be simple. We had been playing cards for 2 hours when she arrived. So, the first line tells us that the action started in the past. Okay, so it is we had been playing cards for some time, that is for 2 hours. So, it continued for some time, which is for 2 hours, and it was in progress before another action happened. And that action is when she arrived. Now, let's look at the second sentence and let's do the same thing. She had been writing a novel for a few months when she became ill. So here, the action of writing started and the action continued for some time, that is, for a few months. And that was in progress. But another action took place, that is, she became ill. So let's understand one thing. There are two actions here. In fact, two past actions. And the second action or the later action is always going to be in simple past tense. And that is our trick. So, which one is the later action? Which part of the sentence is in the simple past tense? Yes, it's she arrived. It is the second action and it is in the simple past tense. Now, what is the second action in the second sentence? Yes, when she became ill. Now, we have gotten some clarity, but then to further clarify it completely, let's look at the past perfect continuous tense on our timeline. This is our timeline, this is the past, this is the present, and this is the future. So, let's look at the second sentence and let's show it on the timeline. She had been writing a novel for a few months when she became ill. So, she started in the past and it is a continuous action for few months. She has been writing and maybe that's why she became sick here. But then afterwards, she did continue writing. So, when an action that started in the past, which was continued for a few months and that particular action is in progress, before another action, and that action is of becoming ill. So well, that is our past perfect continuous tense. So see you in our next session. Till then, stay home, stay safe.